for the people to go out and invest in, into a system.
Herschel Nation, what was it like being Chattanooga's first TV sportscaster?
They are all people who have helped mold and make this industry exactly what it is today.
When Doris first came to WDEF, she was just a mere child.
I can remember back when they moved down here on South Broad, they had a big open house. They invited the public to come out and go through the building and tour it. And you got to meet all the on-air personalities. And my mom and dad brought me up here. I was actually about, I think, 9 years old then. And when we were preparing for our 50th anniversary, I was looking through all the old photographs, and there was a picture of my mom and dad standing in line. I was kind of behind the crowds, but waiting in line to come in and tour the station. I never dreamed that in 9 more years, I'd be working here. And I was just, I guess it's like a lot of people, you're so excited because television back then was really, I mean, it was, and it is now, but it was something special.
A lot of good things have happened at News 12, and a lot of those things can be traced directly to Doris Ellis.
It's, you know, it's been a pleasure looking back over the years and feeling like somehow that you were a part of that, that what insignificant part you had worked for the greater good of the community. And you know, I really have. I have loved every minute I've worked at Channel 12.
But you know, he's also allowed me to work at a station that I love working there.
Looking back over the almost 50 years, that's one of the most important things I think in any job, is to look forward to coming to work every day. And that was something I really did, you know, because it was something different every day. It was something you didn't know what to expect, but you knew it wasn't going to be a boring day.
When I worked at Channel 12 in Chattanooga, Doris was forever locking herself in the ladies' room, with Margie Scott having to come to her rescue.
There have been so many funny things that have happened, and that is what has made, I think, working here so much fun, because everybody has got such a great sense of humor, and you know, it's fun to, it's work, but at the same time, you know, you have a good time while you're doing it.
Yeah, the good Lord has been so good to me. I have had the most wonderful life anybody can ever ask.
I have really been blessed working here at the station. It's something that it's never the same, depending on what we're doing, if we're doing a project, if we're doing Riverbend, if we're doing a telethon, or your hours are never the same. And I could have never done that without the support of my family, particularly my husband. He was always, and has been always, supportive of me. And my darling daughter, Kara, she has been always there for me, even to the point that when we did Riverbend or we're doing a Shred It, she would always come out and pitch in. And of course, my brothers and sister-in-laws, and you know, just and I have been so fortunate to have a great step family that have always been there for me. But most of all, it's the WDEF family that I will really, really miss. And it is a family. Everybody seems like family here. And it's something that I won't forget.
I get up in front of,
and I may drop in from time to say hi. I'm not going to let them forget me.
And,
and I certainly won't forget them.
I'm so glad we had this time together, just to have a laugh or sing a song. Seems we just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say so long. There's a time you put aside for dreaming, and a time for things you have. The
time